come back here home and go to Juja Preparatory. And I have Edward Kitili right now on standby. Remember, at the Juja Preparatory, we have the under 15 leg currently going on. And Edward, probably if you can bring us up to speed, you know, what has transpired during the morning and what should we expect from this league?
Well, Robinson, I can hear quite well. It's a really cold morning, cold afternoon here, really at the Juja Preparatory School, where we have been having several games, featuring, of course, the Kenya Harambee Stars under 15 squad and other, of course, other teams, including the Kakoro Academy, here to in some brief, of course, tournament here. Of course, now I'm going to speak to the technical director of the FKF, that is Kenya Harambee Stars under 15 squad, to just give me more details on what has been happening here since morning. Coach, first of all, welcome to KTN Scotland. Just introduce yourself and tell me what has been happening here.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm happy to be with you. My name is Andreas Pia. I'm the technical director of FKF. And we are here and to make a very nice tournament facilitated by also Juja Preparatory School, which is a partner of FKF. So we are happy to give the possibility to the children, to the under 15 boys, to have a tournament, to know each other and to enjoy the game of football.
The camp has now been going on for quite some time, that is almost a week now. How has it been so far?
Yeah, we are training intensively. We try to improve the technical skills to give them match exposure, and we are training also twice a day. So we are happy to have them together and also to improve and to develop this team.
Many out there players, they have the talent to be here and of course would like to join the Harambee Stars under 15 squad, maybe for the future prospect of the national team. What are the categories you used to, or criteria used to select the team which is here, and how can someone join probably?
The door is open to enter, also to go out. So we are searching for talents. We are searching for talents with a perspective to have a good future as football players. So it's not only to have talent, it's also hard work. It's also organized work, it's consistency over a long time, working over a long time with qualified coaches and with good conditions. The nutrition must be also good. So, and like we see, we are in a school here, in Juja Preparatory School. We want to complete the football skills and the football abilities also with the school.
Several players from the school here and others from across the country. How was that done, choosing the seven players from here and a few from other national schools, of course? How was that done?
Yeah, we did a very good selection. We scouted the players. We built it a scouting team formed by football specialists, experienced coaches, and we chose the best players. It was practically the final tournament last year for under 13, and now this team together went up to the under 15, almost together.
Looking at the standard of the soccer in the country now, we've just gone 8 ranks below there in the FIFA rankings. How ready is the country now to prepare the future team for the country, now starting there with the under 15s?
It's absolutely the right age to begin to develop players. Under 13, under 15, this is the best age to learn football and to remain with the skills all the life. This is the basic of football. So it's very important to begin and to continue in this age and to continue until the senior age. So I can only recommend to all academies to start so early as possible.
So far today we've been having a tournament here. You have one more week to prepare before the 20th tournament. Yes. How ready do you think the team is going to be?
First of all, exactly in this age, the results are not very important. Important is the development. But of course, if you are playing good and if you perform good, the results are also coming. So we expect good results also.
All right, thank you. Thank you. That is, of course, Andreas Spears, the team technical director of the under 15 Harambee Stars, of course. Let me just now cross over to a player to just give you a brief experience of how it is like to be part of the Harambee Stars under 15 squad. Now I'm being joined by a player. Kindly just introduce yourself and how is the experience here today?
My name is James Gashago. I'm the captain of the under 15 national team. The experience has been good because I've learnt a lot of training sessions. I've learnt a lot of techniques of passing and different things. I'm really happy to be in the under 15 national team.
What do you aim to achieve after this camp of the 14 days and for moving on to the tournament later on? What are your expectations?
Expectations that we'll do really well because this tournament here is to help us like gel as a team. I think that after this and after the training sessions we're going to be given, we will learn a lot and we might gel as a team, and in the further tournaments we will win.
How do you think your team is performing so far, being the future of the national squad here?
Our future is really bright. I think that if we continue the same way with the same coaching, we'll go really far.
All right, thank you so much. That is one of the players here of the Harambee Stars under 15 squad. Just tell me how it is important to be part of such a junior team for the national squad here. This is where the future is being developed now. In the next few years, we'll be having the next, of course, the Mark Nord and Mariga, and of course, the next Victor Wanyama's now. Back to you, Robinson.
Well, thanks a lot, Edward Kitili at Juja Preparatory School, talking to Andreas Piers, who's the technical director for Football Kenya Federation. And he's been among the people that are spearheading the process of scouting for the national team. And also speaking to Nerito Gashagwa, who's the captain, for the under-15 national team.